like. But the one lining of the landing beaches, okay. So by closing the locks at high tide, it was easy to flood the marshland. So at the ship headquarter, when they saw the weather very, very bad, they decided to postpone the landing by one day. But in the meantime, some ships in khaki clothing to let the German believe it was a concentration of troops. They did all kind of deceptive operations. They had along the coast of southern England empty trucks. But gradually, you know, as the French resistance was doing all kind of sabotage, then it started to become very repressive. And the American used it to build an airstrip, a temporary airstrip. The French were amazed how the Americans were building those airstrips in a record time, because they would bring everything in crates. They had huge metal walls, they would lay the metal on the ground, and the airstrip was not even finished. That airplanes were landing. You see the stone on the right? On June 6th, you always have an American flag flying here. And they were building those very fast. They were not even finished that airplanes were landing to bring supplies from England. And they were taking off with the casualties, with the wounded. And that's what made a difference with World War I, because a lot of the casualties were airlifted to be...
Okay. So we are going to take direction Cherbourg.
And it was the day that General de Gaulle, the French general, who was in charge of the Free French in England, with Ike, with the commanders there, he was stationed in England, and he's shaking hands with the guys arriving on Sword Beach, the French commandos. The tall guy with the kepi is de Gaulle inside. You see the poppy wreath over there. So, with 1,800 five names on the wall of the missing in alphabetical order.
Si tu peux t'arrêter juste quelques minutes là, ce serait bien.
So this cemetery, any time of the year you have visitors, you know, because it's in town. So you see it has flowers at the bottom of each stone. Very pretty. It's under the British War Grave Commission. You have a few Australian, a few New Zealander buried there as well.